Here we go. Orbital shipyards. And we've actually built a space dock now. Was it in the system? Yes, it was on this planet. Which means that... oh wait, we've built the space dock, but the system where we were building the research labs was this other one. Ha, damn it. So we won't get the extra research income for now. Well, whatever. Next level of quantum physics will already unlock us the next level of physics, tier 3, which I think is going to be too expensive for us to even consider right now. So let us disinvest into that research category. Let's finish these level 2 stealth coatings. We might want to go for level 3 in, directly. Because if he's keeping up with tech at all, he might get better sensors as well. What else do we want? I think we want shields or armor and or armor, get some defenses upon our ships so we can actually take some damage. We could go for power 4 and get larger antimatter reactors, which I'm guessing are going to give us a plus 4 movement bonus. No, the small antimatter reactors only give us a plus 2, so they would probably give us a plus 3. That's an option. I think for now we're going to go with the better sensors, and then we can decide what else to do. You are still here, or you are have just arrived there as an extra ship. Oh, what's this? And why is this ship mine? Is that a random event? I don't see anything. Well, I haven't seen a random event. I guess he must have had a random event. And then... I didn't get any message for that. So I guess this ship mutinied and switched to my side. Let's look at what it has. It has an explosive torpedo, level 1, which is strange. Since we've seen that he has level 2 torpedoes. I guess this is just one of the mistakes this thing makes then. Advanced Unit Launch 1, are you showing that now? I'm pretty sure that wasn't there before. Armor 2, I don't think that was there before either. Yeah, I thought I saw Torpedoes 2 with him as well. Might just have been looking at my list and thought it was his list. So, net us, we can thrust just large nuclear reactors, I think it's 3 moves then. What's this, a neural core? Provides a control center. Its command capability resistance to boarding and bioweapons equal to 20 crew and generates 5 damage a second, but the 5 damage is only for the core itself, I'm guessing. So that satisfies the 2 bridge requirements. Level 1 armor, nothing on the other decks. Level 1 radar dish. Okay, here's missile ships. Which might not be ideal because we have a reasonable amount of heavy warships and not a reasonable amount of PD on our fleet. What do we do with this ship though? If he sends his ships to chase this town, I'm not sure that this will be able to run circles around them. But we can try. How about you just go there? Try to warp through that point. Just to see what's behind it, and I don't think the ship is going to survive very long. I guess it would make a decent addition to my fleet if it got that, if it could meet up with my fleet. But yeah, you for now move the 4 tiles onto that one. You can stay there, I guess. We'll jump in. We'll jump the fleet through. Are we? No, we're just going to move the fleet through that warp point, and we're going to warp you through and see if it's clean on the other side. Let's reconsider the composition of this. This ship is actually running lower on supplies, lower and lower. Probably because it's sharing with these, which are... Yeah, they have like 1500 supplies each, and this has 1900, so it's considered equal-ish. Or equalized. The fleets also always try to equalize the amount of supply they have inside them. And it's done by absolute numbers, not by percentages, which is how you can have one ship that appears to be low on supply and the other ones aren't. I'm not sure if this actually wastes any supply generation. Yeah, so these have a lot of torpedoes. That's the old sensor ship. Should detach that actually. Should have probably detached that a couple turns ago already. And to these, well, they have autocannons. They can shoot seekers. I'm not sure how well they do though. Could try into simulators. Five of these cruisers versus three Arachites, two smallpox, and another heart disease. Let's detach the scout ship. You were going to go this way. Let's simulate. Five of these versus two of these and two of these, right? So it's good. And what was the... this one was the ship. Did we just build the tier 2? What's the difference even? Armor. I don't think we have armor on that thing. Not the advanced one. So, what would this look like? I predict that this will end in disaster. But we should also look at the damage types. Yep, there's one shift of me down. Not out of ammo or anything, no, not yet. We have extra ammo on these things. Autocannon doing God's work. Oh, this autocannon's actually dead already, so he's just shooting with his one gun there. So maybe this doesn't end in disaster, huh? Do you see that? Did that thing just shoot its torpedo? What happened to it? It certainly did not do its full damage. Didn't even do sick. Oh wait, it might have done 60 damage. Because the damage types probably skip a decent amount of the armor. So okay, the encounter with that fleet would not end in immediate disaster. But I don't necessarily want to recommend it either. For instance, in this simulated fight, this ship's been disabled. We don't have any repair ability. Let's look at the damage types. We can see them under help. You usually go for the data files or something like this, but you can actually see the damage types reasonably well in game as well. Antimatter damage type, energy. Energy is probably gonna be lasers. Penetration percent 92% on armor, a little less on the other ones. 92% goes through the armor and onto the hull, and 8% of the damage is actually going to be applied to the armor. So lasers are good if you want to penetrate armor. No interaction with shields listed. Explosive is what the missiles have. They penetrate shields a little bit, but most of the damage gets caught by the shields, or they penetrate armor a lot. Okay, so if we want to have defenses against shields, then we really want to have defenses against missiles, and we really want to have shields. I guess that puts shields up a little higher on our research list. Then there's kinetic damage type, which gets half stopped by shields and has no interaction with armor, which means armor will absorb this quite well. Huh. That actually makes these level 5 mass drivers I have a little less efficient than I would love them to be. And makes me think more torpedoes is going to be the answer. This does not have any interaction with shields listed, so shields can tank lasers just as well as armor can tank kinetic weapons then. And explosive missiles are just going to have a little bit of penetration everywhere. The more we know. So what do we do with that information? This ship is still going to explore there. You. We're going to decloak you for this turn. They could move 1, 2, 3 and see up until there. We could move to here. We could also see here, but they might also move here. No, if they're going this way, they're probably going to move here and then there. Which means 1, 2, 3 and 1 sensor tile. 1, 2, 3 and 1 sensor tile, yeah. Which means we can still move to these tiles just fine. So let us move here while uncloaked. In order not to use our supply storage, we only have enough for 2 more turns of cloaked movement. After that, we need to stay still for a while uncloaked. And yeah, that's one of the colonizers. You can go here. Wait, we should manually load the stuff we had for you on before. You should load fighters, there aren't any other fighters, so we can just do generic fighter load. And you will actually go through this warp point, huh? Interesting. Maybe it's just faster to go to this warp point if you go this way. Maybe not. I'm not sure how much I trust SE5's pathfinding capabilities. So, yeah, this one is going to be out of stuff to build after this turn. The question is, do we even want to build anything else? Because our treasury is going down. It's still going to be a few turns until we can start building new metropolises. The colony type here reset again. I don't know if I should even bother with that. It's not like it does anything. I think the colony type is one of the ways the AI remembers what stuff is. And I like to have it too, so when I look at the lists, then I can see what I intend the planet to be. So if I have researched central computers and want to upgrade all my research planets, I can just filter the list for research planets. You know, you can also filter it for whatever it outputs, but that's one of the ways you can do it. So you're going to go here and you're going to combine with your better censorship. You are going to stay there. I think that's it for this turn then. Wonder what'll happen. Wonder if he's going to chase this. I wonder if I'm going to see what's behind this warp point. Because this system is unfortunately pretty empty. It's not his homeworld. I'm guessing there's going to be a connection through here, which might mean that it would be better to invade him through this place. Well,